I support Planned Parenthood. That is to say, I fully support people planning to be parents when they're able to do so. You know, when they have a steady job and a place to live, and a spouse. In typical leftist fashion, they named an organization that almost exclusively performs abortions the exact opposite of what it really is. You know, kind of like the Affordable Care Act. A more accurate name for Planned Parenthood would have been to call it Stopping Parenthood. But this video isn't really about that organization anyway. In America, the devastation of single motherhood is bordering crisis levels. Just look at the statistics. Children from single-parent households consistently have worse outcomes. They're more likely to get in trouble with the law. They're more likely to get addicted to drugs. They're more likely to drop out of school and run away. And they're more likely to become single parents themselves, putting their kids at an even bigger disadvantage. Currently, Black children are born to single-parent households about 70% of the time. That's a staggering and horrific statistic. The thing about it, though, is that it doesn't matter which community it happens in, to the children it happens to, the statistics are frighteningly similar. If you're white or Black and born into a low-income single-parent household, you have about the same chances of falling into crime, drugs, dropping out of school, and becoming a single parent yourself. The outcomes aren't race-specific, which means that it's not about race. It's just happening in the Black community more, which explains why so many young Black males are falling into crime and drugs. I do want you to know that this is no attack on single mothers, but the question we need to answer is, how do we stop children from being born into that situation? Sure, Planned Parenthood has an answer, but I don't believe it to be moral or a solution, and I don't think it's a problem that government can fix either. They've actually made it worse by trying to help. By supporting single mothers, the government has unintentionally incentivized single motherhood. I was telling this to a Black friend of mine, and she got this look on her face. I thought she was going to disagree with me, but then she said, "When I was a kid, my dad would sneak into the house at night and leave early in the morning. And if anyone came around and asked us kids, we were told to lie and say that we hadn't seen him." Now, how sad is that? And eventually he did leave, because how long could a man possibly live like that? The solution to the problem is easier said than done. It's responsibility. Single mothers, you're going to have to work harder than most to keep your kids on the right path. And guys, stop impregnating women you don't care about, and take responsibility for it when you do. You know, we have a popular TV show that provides young women with paternity tests so that they can figure out who the father of their kids are. And when it's announced that some guy is not the father, the crowd cheers. Oh, yay, another fatherless kid. I'm afraid that until we take responsibility for our own actions, both men and women, this country will continue to slowly turn into an episode of The Maury Show. And that's the painfully sad, simple truth.
Thanks for watching. Please consider becoming a supporting member of Blue Collar Logic. Look for the link in the description and give what you can.